Finally tonight from us, and maybe finally forever for him, just how out of touch is the AFL train wreck Brendan Fevola? Or is it ultimately the artificial world that sports stars like Fevola live in? Booze, gambling, at least one high-profile girl thing, and general public larrikinism, all of the above have got serial offender Fev into trouble. So when does being a boisterous lad, a serial naughty boy if you like, become socially unacceptable? Why shouldn't there be a cut-off point for public tolerance? Here's 6pm's Leanne West.
The plug's been pulled, probably for the last time, on the AFL's problem child.
Brendan had engaged in serious or willful misconduct through persistent breaches of his obligations as an AFL player to the club.
While Fevola continued his treatment for alcohol and gambling issues, the Brisbane Lions conceded their high-profile experiment had failed. The last straw, his New Year's Eve visit to the Brisbane Watch House.
I can't sit here and say that it wasn't a mistake because obviously he's now left our football club.
Lions management had staked its reputation on Favola's signing, perhaps encouraged by Ben Cousins at Richmond, but had Fevola already been given too many chances?
Ask any coach and they'll tell you a troubled star player is much more likely to get a second chance than a less talented teammate. Big names put bums on seats. They also improve a club's chances of winning the ultimate prize.
Oh, I think the lure of a premiership, can make people believe that, they can get it right. Most coaches and clubs think that they've got the resources and the ability to be able to turn a player around.
Sometimes, though, the sporting walk of shame becomes a journey of redemption. Todd Carney, last year's winner of rugby league's highest individual honour, the Dally M Medal, had been sacked by his club and kicked out of the NRL after a string of alcohol-related incidents. He spent a year playing bush footy, earning his keep as a barman, before the Sydney Roosters gave him a lifeline. He hasn't looked back.
I've known Todd since he was 15. He's essentially a great person. Not just a standard person, he's a really, really good person. With good family. He made some bad decisions. Just did them at the wrong time and got really exposed for them and learnt some fabulous lessons about life.
While Todd Carney is in his early 20s, Fevola is 30, and Robert Walls believes AFL clubs are much less likely to punt on bad boys in the wake of the Brisbane Lions experience.
You've got to remember he came from a club, Carlton, which in the decade he played there, they were not successful. I don't think the discipline was strong enough. So he'd been given enough rope, and I wouldn't have thought that at 29 he was going to change when he went north.
NRL coach Matthew Elliott says he never bets on horses, but he'll always consider gambling on a person. It's how you do it that counts.
A lot of what we do is the wrong way around. We tell the player our expectations of them. Really, it should be the other way around. Get the player to tell you the expectations of themselves and what they're trying to achieve. Write it down, and if they're outside of that, you just show them the piece of paper that, well, mate, this is what you said you were going to do, and this is what you're doing. Maybe you should do it somewhere else.